Welcome to Biomutant. You'd be drier in a swamp. Okay to smile at the growing light. Wood scrap, the one kind of scrap you could actually still find growing. A smart foe would leave. Don't see that every day. Now you understand better. That's an improvement. can always find some use for rubber scrap. E-waste, the stuff you need. Rubber scrap lying around like that. You located the village named Lobliderk.
Legenebo yape bioyo.
Peddler is
Gunenyai Maja.
Seems thrilled you grabbed all those glitter moths. Complains it's heart-busting raising young ones when the world end leaves no future for them. But they think Maytimes collecting a set of pets might help them hold up. They're too busy watching the young ones to find them critters to pet, but maybe you have them. Says they're small and fast. Just keep your peepers peeled. Claims those petables are all over the place. Just gotta scoop them up. Once you get enough critters for each kidling, that should be plenty. Without enough critters, the kidlings get stanky cranky. Says you're the kind of end friend they all need. So cool that the kidlings got their pets. Lots of love to roll around. Every day, everything seems like it happens at once. Let's see. Make sure you don't walk off a cliff while you're night blind. That there's the guppy hut. Might be some gill-catching gear in there. Oh, that's rare. Rubber scrap is too much fun, so stretchy. If you're tired, maybe find a place to rest. This is Guppy Grotto. Hope you haven't seen the sky for the last time. What a wonderful place to hide. Let's see. They've been waiting for you. Taking control, the scouts have reported activity nearby that's worth looking into before you enter the fort. They've managed to roll a bang ball against the fort, and the plan is to... Figures a plane torch will snuff out when it's thrown, so you need to add some boom powder to make it inextinguishable. Being late to being early. It's time to set the rival tribe free. Inflict as little damage as possible as you make your way through to their Sifu. Convincing the Sifu. The Megamuck in that cage looks like it could... Just get out of the Megamuck's way. Good thing you're not claustrophobic. The wire claw looks like it's strong enough to pull down a gate. But you just need to aim straight, shoot and pull, and the Pishoot tribe supports natural evolution on the dogma that only the strong survive. They want to help evolution on its way by conquering the tribes, as they're all too weak in their convictions. Anybody home? He didn't expect it would go down this way. It'll be hard to talk your way out of a fight. He's not sure if you're likable enough to just give up the fort without a fight. He realizes a peaceful end would be best. He'll entrust the fort to you. The rival Sifu is defeated, and the destiny of their tribe is in your hands. You are free to choose their fate, but not free from the consequences of your choice. He'll leave it up to you to decide the fate of the rival Sifu, but suggests you be merciful. Thinks it's a good gesture to offer support to others when you can see that they need it. And with that, you're spinning your own fate, good or bad, never to be undone. Side by side they'll stand until order and stability is reinstituted. They've achieved a great thing for the tribe and the land by winning the war. The other tribes will see your side of things with time. You'll succeed quickest by helping others succeed. This is why uniting the tribes is so important. It's only together that you'll stand strong. When you first met, the world was divided and filled with fear. But you've come a long way on your path towards a world ruled by truth and justice. He says it'll take some time for the tribes to come together as one, even if the tribe war has ended. Saving the Tree of Life will be a task you have to tackle on your own. You know better than anyone that the fate of the world is still at stake. You need a world where everyone is guided only by their conscience. The fate of the world depends on the triumph of good. The Tree of Life still stands, and it's up to you to make sure it does so all the way to the end. It's the Pichu Nanchuk. Strange not having the sky above.